Welcome back to Let's Play Disco Elysium Blind. Hoping we can get past the waterlock, drawbridge type thing. Hey, let the police flick the switch! Okay, well, we're the police. So let's give it a try. A rusting control panel with loose wires dangling out from the hole where an indicator light used to be, and a mechanical lever sitting in the middle. Pull the lever again. You grab the handle and pull the lever up. As soon as the metal connects with the contact pins, you hear a loud clunk. Then, the water lock starts moving. Awesome. Okay, the lieutenant looks across the canal. If we ever need to get to the coast, then this is the way. But please, contain your wanderlust for now. I don't want us to get sidetracked, not with everything that's going on. Well, I want to find another way to get that body down. Esprit de Corps says, focus on one thing, achieve it, then the next, he thinks. That's the task chain. Alright. Let's run out the clock! Something about... Can we just run across here? Is that what we do? Yeah. There's stuff here. Money? Nice. The radio relay hums with electricity. Breaker box to power the radio pylon above you. Maybe there's something inside? Ahead, decades-old concrete defenses. Children play on them now. Oh yeah, there's money in there. Nice. We are gonna let our wanderlust take control, because I'm hoping another way to get that body down appears somehow. Maybe we'll run into someone else who can help? I don't know. Magnesium. Traffic beyond the gate. More abandoned motor lorries. The sign says, no entry. Someone scribbled an inverted star on it. Ooh. I got Jamrock Biker Cop Sunnies. Plus one empathy, minus one logic. Under clothes. For taking your Harmel Reuse Supersonic out for a ride on the streets of Jamrock, where your heart is buried. Is it worth it to get minus one logic and plus one empathy? Our logic is 5. Our empathy is 4. Well, this would make empathy 4 and logic 5. I'm not sure. But I'll hold on to them for now. I guess we're not getting out here. So that's another drawbridge type. Someone has broken down the fence and the barbed wire. Well, maybe we can get around and find our way over there. Swings? The swing is missing, and no one's been here for a long time. Inland Empire says, rust peels off the bent iron posts of the swing. the wind whistles through the skeleton of the small house behind you. There's desolation everywhere. What happened here? In this yard? The lieutenant looks at the small building. A flock of gray swallows takes off in the distance. Visual calculus says he's assessing the situation. How long ago was it abandoned? Kim says someone thought they could have a summer house in a block obscure for cheap. It didn't work out. They abandoned it about a decade ago. Wait, what's a block obscure? A black block, a part of the city left unremoved after the war, or one that has fallen to gang violence, or has become inhospitable in some other way. Encyclopedia says, on aerial photos, block obscures look like dark squares, hence their name. Well, it's spelled differently here. Maybe it's spelled this way when it's plural. So this part of the coast is a block obscure? Practically. It's not an official term in any way, but... He spreads his arms. Look around. No sewage, broken power lines, crime, drunks. Life is tough in the blocks. It's no place to build a summer house. You think maybe they left something useful behind? Oh! No! I wanted to... Damn it.
Yes?
Never mind, I hit the wrong thing. I hate that. They did leave something useful behind. They left money. And money's always useful. Wish it was more, but hey, what do you want? That's for free. Glory, says the graffito, to the ghosts of us. Huh. What's in here? A barrel? Okay. More magnesium. A tarp of some kind? Someone has left their music collection beneath the tarpaulin. Oh. Tape. Smallest church in St. Sands. Could we use this to sing karaoke? The tape you found from a shack on the coast. The A side has Smallest Church in St. Sands written on it, while the B side is supposed to contain the instrumental version. Requires a boombox to play. Well, we have one of those. The porta reel is just what you needed. The reels attach to the apparatus with a satisfying click. The tape is routed behind the magnetic reader. You press the large button marked commencer and the tape starts spinning. There's a small delay before the song starts playing. Press your ear against the speaker. It sounds like someone's moving in the room, getting comfortable. Then the organ starts playing a simple, melancholic tune. Echoing in the hallway, a lone singing voice joins in, telling you about the tiniest church in St. Sands, surrounded by an even tinier yard. You almost feel the seaside mist on your skin. It's mega sad. Inland Empire says, within seconds you know, this is the one. The real stuff you've been looking for. The one you trashed your room to that class J. The one you trashed your room to that class J told you about. Perform it. A click, then silence for a bit. Then the tape stops spinning. Could I sing this for karaoke? I think I could sing this. Inland Empire says, of course you could sing this. You could take sad to a whole new level with this, and you already know the lyrics since you've listened to it, like, a million times. Encyclopedia says, yep, they're all here. All three verses. And the B-side of the tape contains the instrumental version. It's like the world itself is telling you to do it. Only one obstacle stands in your way. What? Gart. You have to convince Gart to let you sing karaoke in the whirling. After you've won him over, you can express yourself, let the pain out, make everyone understand. The lieutenant looks at you as you remove the tape from the boombox. He doesn't say anything. Okay. Convince Gart to let you sing karaoke. Alright. Wonder how easy that would be, or non-easy. This is nothing in here. I guess that's it. These buildings are in the way. Yeah. Gonna run around, okay. Yeah, I am definitely looking around. A banged up fuel canister. A dented stainless steel canister for transporting and storing heavy fuel oil. A logo on its side has been partially stripped over years of use. The government issued red dyed fuel oil inside looks like paint, though it smells much, much worse. What's this? Part of a damaged... Oh, sunken motor carriage. A banged-up motor carriage lies half-submerged in the icy water, slowly sinking into the Insulindian Ocean. Only the cabin top, rear wheels, and the engine remain visible. Empathy says, it must be cold and lonely down there in the icy water. Interfacing says, the seawater has already started to corrode the metalworks. So I'm feeling bad for the carriage. Carriage in the sea? Where did this come from? Kim says, my guess is it started its journey from the plaza where it backed through the fence. Let's investigate, Kim. I agree, the lieutenant replies, curious look in his eyes. We should definitely investigate. Inland Empire says, you get a sudden sinking feeling. Stomach acid comes up as you look at the motor carriage in the deep, dark, cold water. Is it mine, then? Run your hand over the cold metal. The motor carriage is properly sunk in the ice, or stuck in the ice. Getting it out would require a team of specialists. Oh, this is ice? For some reason I thought this was like a beach or something. I didn't even notice the chunks over here and stuff. Interfacing says, a single day in this salty seawater would ruin most vehicles, but this one looks worn even in places the salt water hasn't touched it. What is the make of this motor carriage? Can I see a logo? The logo is too deep in the murky water. You can't make it out, but you do see a monkfish float by. How long has it been here? The ice hasn't closed around the vehicle yet. He leans forward to peek into the cold water. My guess is it's been here since last Saturday or Sunday. Visual calculus says the estimate is correct. The incident probably occurred on Sunday evening. Jacob Ears? Who is that? What should we do? Let's wait for the low tide and see what's inside. Great idea, Logic says. Then we can get the things inside. The Joyrider must have left something good inside. Guns, papers, maybe a cool jacket? A Joyrider jacket? Esprit de Corps says a Joyrider jacket. You feel a strange connection to this Joyrider. Maybe he's from some kind of Joyrider's district and likes blue and white racing livery? Like a cop would. How long will it take for the low tide to come in? I don't know. An hour or two, tops? Sit on the swing and wait for the tide to recede. All right. As you sit down in the old, rusty playground, the world around you becomes very silent. Nothing but the sound of seagulls high above in the sky, echoing like distant laughter. Ice cracks around the blue motor carriage in the sea. Hold on, it looks very blue, pointing to the sunken vehicle. Yes, yes it does. What's your favorite blue thing? Lieutenant is staring at the wreck. Let me think about it. He's actually seriously thinking about this. Let's whistle a tune! And succeed. The tune on your lips forms a strange yet undeniably beautiful contrast with the surrounding bleakness. It was literally the only game, guys, that would have you run a check in order to whistle a song. I like it. I healed morale 0 because I'm already full. The lieutenant gives you a quick glance, then, still looking straight ahead, he joins you with a higher pitched and slightly more melodic trill. Conceptualization says two birds on a wire, whistling by the seaside, looking at the water and a sunken car. The clouds pass in the sky, and the shadow of the swing moves like the hour hand on a timepiece. 30 minutes have passed. Rhetoric says, looks like this might take a while. Time to present a good topic for discussion. So was your dad also, you know, pointing to your eyes? I'm pretty sure I told you already, didn't I? My dad and mom are both half Seolite. I miss my parents. Clouds on the horizon grow darker, and the shadow of the swing set keeps climbing. You hear the distant rumble of the city. 30 minutes pass. If you have to side with either the strikers or the shipping company, who would you choose? Luckily, I am already a member of an independent organization, and therefore do not have to choose between a rock and a hard place. That's an answer to the question. But if someone puts a gun to your head? Your voice echoes on the water, strange and out of place in the environment. 30 more minutes pass. Can you make out the mark now? Detective, I've been able to make out the mark ever since we arrived. I find it odd that you haven't. It's a Capri, Model 40. His eyes turn to you. Interfacing says, yes. Why haven't you? It's a simple and rugged machine, favored by working men, government offices. He pauses to think. Firefighters, animal control people, you know, those kinds of people. I'm still wondering if it's his. Our protagonist, squint your eyes and say, is that a number on the side? Yes, 41. What do you think it stands for? Well, it's not the answer to life, the universe, and everything. That's 42. It's as if he knows what it stands for, but wants you to say it. It's pedagogical. Logic says, does he know something about the driver of this vehicle? Oh. Is that my district? I hate guessing. District something? A precinct? Something municipal. Rub your temples. You're getting a horrible headache. A precinct, yes. He tilts his head and continues in a soft voice. A police precinct. Precinct 41. Your precinct. Inland Empire says, a massive pit opens up in your stomach and the most terrible feeling comes over you. Volition says, nope. Just nope. Say no to this, Harry. No. Yes, your car is in the sea. Face it, so we can start dealing with this. No, I mean seriously, it's just a coincidence. The lieutenant just shakes his head. Oh my god, it's mine! I drove my car into the sea? Damage morale. I'm afraid, yes. It looks like you drove your police motor carriage into the sea after you jumped across the canal. The badge, the gun, and now this. The lieutenant adjusts his glasses and doesn't say anything. Inland Empire says, there is also a fourth thing you've lost. A fourth thing? More precious than the gun, the badge, and the motor carriage combined, lost forever into the deepest of seas. My pride? Something that was part of me. They're not going to take me back after this, are they? People are more valuable than machines. He's trying to cheer you up now. Training a police officer is even more costly. How do we get it out? Detective, he says almost gently, we don't. A rescue operation really isn't viable at this point. So it's just going to be there like that? I'm afraid it will have to be there like that for many years. He looks around. Look at it. Parts of it might be salvageable, but overall this machine is a write-off. I can still fix it. That is very unlikely, the lieutenant replies with a sigh. All the electrics are toast. That goes for the electromagnetic steering and the brake systems as well. You'd be lucky to find one undamaged component in there. He shakes his head. In a few months, there'll be nothing but rust left of this vehicle. It'll be cheaper to buy a new one. Well, not cheaper. This motor carriage cost 40,000 real, but in the long run, it still makes more sense to buy a new machine than try to refurbish this. People are going to be angry at me, aren't they? In Precinct 41. Let's face it, this is a substantial loss to your district's budget. He's avoiding your gaze now. I mean, my station only has four other vehicles in addition to my kinema. Logic says this was 20% of the station's vehicular budget. I doubt this, but just want to see what the result would be. Maybe I was in pursuit of someone. Of whom? The lieutenant looks skeptical. I don't think so. If anything, you were probably drunk. Well, at least I can see what's in there now. Maybe I'll find my badge, my gun. No, the gun was sold. Yes, let's go take a look. This is done. What's done? A half-insane joyrider has jumped over the canal. See if you can find evidence of his reckless activity in West on the coast. Yeah. We found evidence. Okay, level up. What do I want to level up? Keeping your morale up. Okay. Okay, so I'm good at putting the schmooze onto people at high levels and resistant to their charms. Let me put one into suggestion. Yeah, well, let's go see what we can find. My badge! And a commander's jacket. RCM badge. Nice. So here's the jacket. This is good, because he plus one esprit de corps and visual calculus, as opposed to this jacket, which is esprit de corps. Nice. A black uniform jacket with RCM signature white rectangle on its right sleeve and backside. Letters inside the collar read LTN-2JFR. The jacket is of exceptional quality, other than some minor wear and tear. Awesome. Now the badge. Thick blue piece of acrylic, covering a thin leaf of paper with the officer's name and rank on it. Next to the writing, you see a man stare back at you, a younger version of you, already disintegrating inside, but still presentable on the outside. He looks a lot younger. A police badge on which you see the photo of a man, you. Some seaweed is stuck to the back. I found my badge. Kim says at least something good came out of all of this. The lieutenant glances at the badge in your hands. Study the badge. Encased between two durable plastic sheets is a bluish card with lines of information and a watermark in the shape of a street grid of Revachol West. You see a photo, a name, a rank, a document number, the date of issue, and, in the lower right corner, your precinct. Name Harrier DuBois. Kim looks you up and down. It suits you. I'm going to call you Harry, since it's short for Harrier. Harrier? Harrier? Esprit de Corps says no, he's not. He's going to keep calling you Officer when he's angry with you, and Detective when he's not. Does he do that? Wait, what kind of a name is Harrier? It's a wartime name, revolutionary, the kind mothers give their sons during troubled times, like Undying, or Boxer, or Ironhide. You mean there's people walking around with the name Undying? A name like armor, conceptualization says. Why not? Harrier DuBois, it is then. Pleased to make your acquaintance, Harrier DuBois. Look at the photo. The man keeps winking at you with his green-gray eyes. The photo is old, no doubt about that. But the badge is new, logic says. Use an old photo for a new badge. How old? 8, maybe 10 years. The guy in the picture is rather good-looking. He's got a nice haircut and is distinctly lacking in massive sideburns. And he's winking? Why? Why do you think? His face is already contorted by the expression, although it looks less grotesque on him than it does on you now. Rank. Lieutenant Double Efreitor. What is a Lieutenant Double Efreitor? Lieutenant... That's a Y? It looks like a JFR. The lieutenant is a rank above sergeant and below captain. It is the highest rank in the RCM that does field work. I am a lieutenant. And double Efreitor? The title of Efreitor is added to your rank when you decline a promotion to a higher rank. In your case, captain. The lieutenant explains. You've declined twice, thus you're double Efreitor. Declined? There are many reasons why one would do this. The rank above you is your precinct's décomptage. Décomptage. The rank above you in your precinct's décomptage might be taken, or sometimes promoted officers do not want to replace their superiors, out of respect. And sometimes, he continues, they just prefer the type of police work available to their current rank, in your case, lieutenant. Esprit de Corps says, heavy-duty case-solving machine. What's a décomptage? It's the hierarchical system employed by the Revachol Citizens Militia. It means counting down to twos. Encyclopedia says, the countdown is modeled after the dual leadership system employed by the left during the revolution, which in turn was developed by last-century experimental psychologist in the University of Königstein. Kim says, the lowest rank is junior officer, usually teenagers, then there are the patrol officers, then sergeants, lieutenants, and then a captain. That's basically it, except for a few kinks. What kinks? Kinks like satellite officers and the additional Efreitor rank I already explained. Authority says, the long and short of it is you're his superior. Really? Wait, satellite officers? You are given the title of satellite officer if your partner is quickly promoted through the ranks and you rise with him. You don't seem to be a satellite. So you've been putting up with me because we're of the same rank? No, I've been putting up with you because, despite an unconventional approach, you're doing good police work. Really? It matters more than driving your motor carriage into the sea. He smiles encouragingly. And now we've even found your badge. Empathy says he trusts you, for now. Try not to spoil it. He shouldn't. I'm a wreck. I thought my rank was drunk. Yes, apparently you've had a rather successful career in the past, and, he pauses to examine you, this leads me to believe maybe your current situation is only temporary. Thanks. That gives me hope. Good. He says with a quick smile. Turn back to the document. Serial number. That's just a serial number. Revachol, Jamrock, Precinct 41, with some numbers thrown in there for good measure. Okay. Revachol, Jamrock, Jam 41, Precinct 41. The numbers are not there for good measure, logic says. They have an administrative purpose, one that's unfortunately been erased from your memory. Date of issue, 7th of November, 50. 4 months ago. I'm guessing that's when you were promoted to the rank of Lieutenant Double Euphrator. A new badge usually comes with a new rank. You seem to have been doing well then. Logic says, you pretty sure you weren't doing well, but better? Probably yes. Inland Empire says, a lot can happen in 4 months, especially in winter. The winters are never easy on you. Of that, you are sure. Precinct 41? Yes, it's the designation of your Precinct 41. Like mine says 57. The 57th is mostly industrial harbor. A lot of asphalt. The 41st is... He stops. Is it Jamrock? It's a tough station to work in. You have all of Jamrock to cover. That district should have 3 precincts, but money is what it is. Esprit de Corps says, it's no wonder you are like you are, he thinks. But then again, a faint smile. It's a legendary district. And a hell of a station, too. It must be an honor and a curse to work with people like Price, McCoy, Berdyaeva. Encyclopedia says, Roberts, Furbeck, Dimitri. Certainly names from your decompage. Decompage. Well, they don't have the hash mark this time. Accent mark. Flash in your forebrain. Authority says, and you? Is it an honor to work with you? Don't ask him. Ask yourself. Interesting. There's something over here, too. A bottle, drained of all its booze, is frozen to the ice. Well, done is found my badge. Track down your gun is here. Track down my badge was there. I don't even see it now. Unless it's from the day that we... I don't know why I'm trying to find it. Here it is. Found it. Tiny piece of plastic, but we did it. It's a minor miracle. Am I still holding my bag? Yes. Let's see if there are anything that isn't stuck to the ice. Footprints in the snow. They lead away from the accident. Seems the walker was either very confused or drunk out of his mind. Probably both, at least the latter, for sure. The underside of the boat has recently been tarred. Alright, well, I'm gonna call an episode here, guys. Thanks so much for watching. See you next time when we explore more of this area. I'm guessing we're, here. Thanks so much for watching. See you next time, and always seek adventure.